November 15, 2017 marked a puzzling day in maritime history when ARA San Juan, an Argentine Navy submarine, mysteriously vanished with 44 crew members on board. The submarine was on a routine patrol in the serene waters of the South Atlantic near Argentina's coast when it encountered what seemed to be an electrical hiccup. In response to the perplexing disappearance, nations from around the world joined hands in a collaborative search effort, pooling their expertise and resources to solve the intriguing puzzle of the missing submarine and its brave crew. So, did they find the missing submarine? Stay tuned to find out. The ARA San Juan, a TR-1700-class submarine, proudly served the Argentine Navy from 1985 until 2017. This stalwart vessel, born in West Germany, had been sailing the waters since its commissioning on November 19, 1985, and had undergone a significant upgrade between 2008 and 2013, making it ever more resilient. Named after the province of San Juan, a place of significance and pride, it embarked on a seemingly ordinary journey on November 15, 2017. The mission was simple but vital. It was a routine security patrol from Ushuaia to Mar del Plata in Buenos Aires province to keep a watchful eye on Argentina's coastal waters and detect illegal fishing activities. However, that fateful day took an unexpected turn when around 12:30 a.m., the submarine's captain raised the alarm using a satellite phone, reporting that seawater had seeped in through the snorkel, causing trouble in the forward compartments. The intrusion wreaked havoc, leading to a short circuit in the batteries, possibly sparking a fire or smoke. The submarine was ordered to return to the naval base located in Mar del Plata immediately, cutting its mission short. With nerves of steel and a duty-bound spirit, the captain took swift action, isolating the compromised batteries and ensuring that San Juan could still operate using the unaffected batteries in the rear. While submerged, the submarine depended solely on these batteries for its power. As the early hours of the morning unfolded, communication with the vessel remained strong, following the Argentine Navy's standard protocols. At 6 a.m., a typed message reiterated the situation, confirming the captain's previous report made via satellite phone. Then at 7:30 a.m., a message from San Juan's captain was received, affirming that the submarine continued its planned course diligently and that the crew on board was fine. However, this proved to be the last transmission that the Argentine Navy will ever hear from San Juan again. On November 17, 2017, the Argentine Navy made the unsettling announcement that radio contact with the San Juan was lost 2 days before, sending ripples of concern through the maritime world. The last radio contact traced the vessel to a location approximately 430 kilometers off the coast of the southern province of Chubut, near the San Jorge Bay. As the nation held its breath, a Navy spokesman offered cautious hope, stating that they couldn't label the submarine as lost since there were no indications of problems reported from its crew. An initial search was launched around the sub's last known position, but it proved to be a challenging endeavor due to unfavorable nighttime conditions and harsh weather in the area. Despite their best efforts, the mystery deepened as no clues emerged during the initial search, carried out by three Navy ships and two aircraft tirelessly combing through the waters. The submarine's emergency beacon, a vital lifeline in such situations, remained silent, adding to the perplexity. As the investigation unfolded, the Navy revealed that the submarine's limited oxygen supply, sufficient for only about 7 days when submerged, was a pressing concern. With each passing moment, the race against time intensified, and every effort was focused on deciphering the reasons behind the communication blackout. On the 18th of November, prospects of finding the missing Argentine Navy submarine's crew alive brightened when the Defense Ministry reported possible attempts at communication. As the search mission pressed on, 7 satellite calls were detected, believed to have originated from the ARA San Juan submarine, indicating the crew's efforts to re-establish contact. During the late morning and early afternoon, these signals, ranging from 4 to 36 seconds in duration, gave rise to cautious optimism. To aid in pinpointing the location, Argentina enlisted the help of an undisclosed US company specialized in satellite communications. Though the nature of these calls remains a mystery, it was plausible that in dire situations, submerged submarines can release an emergency beacon, an EPIRB, which floats to the surface, allowing it to transmit distress signals via satellite. This possibility fueled the belief that the resilient crew members were still battling the odds and trying to make their presence known. However, the Navy later disclosed that the 7 low-frequency satellite signals had been thoroughly analyzed, leading to the conclusion that they did not originate from the submarine, dashing the hopes of the families of the crew. On November 20th, a glimmer of hope once again surfaced as two vessels involved in the search for the submarine reported hearing a peculiar noise approximately 220 miles from the coast of Patagonia at a depth of around 656 feet. The location of this sound coincided with the expected route the submarine would have taken on its way to Mar del Plata. Initial speculation suggested it might be crew members attempting to attract attention by hammering on the submarine's hull, possibly in Morse code signals. In response, a U.S. Navy aircraft was dispatched to the area to record the acoustic signature of the sound. However, when the analysis of the file was completed, it dashed the rising optimism. The Navy shared the somber news, revealing that the noises were not related to the missing vessel. Instead, they appeared to be from natural sources, potentially arising from the depths of the ocean or marine life. The search for the crew has now reached a critical phase. In a remarkable effort to uncover clues about the fate of the missing submarine, the Argentine ambassador to Austria, a seasoned expert in security, disarmament, and nuclear non-proliferation matters, proposed a novel approach. He suggested using an international hydrophones network, belonging to the Preparatory Commission for the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty Organization, or CTBTO in short, to search for clues. The CTBTO's records were meticulously scoured for any anomalies that could shed light on the submarine's mysterious disappearance. And an anomaly was indeed discovered. On November 23rd, the CTBTO made a significant statement, revealing that two of its hydroacoustic stations had captured a peculiar signal in the depths of the ocean, an abnormal underwater event that was short and violent which resembled an explosion. This discovery intensified the mystery surrounding the missing submarine and its 44 crew members. Adding to the ominous development, the Navy also received a separate report from the United States, detailing a hydroacoustic anomaly detected in the vicinity shortly after the submarine's disappearance. The sound detected during the search raised concerns as it appeared consistent with that of an explosion as well. Despite these alarming findings, the Navy remained cautious in drawing definitive conclusions as it lacked sufficient information to ascertain the exact cause of the detected explosion. As the search for answers persisted, uncertainty loomed, leaving the fate of the ARA San Juan and its brave crew shrouded in mystery. By November 24th, the search and rescue operation for the ARA San Juan involved a massive international effort, with over 30 aircraft and ships from various countries, including Argentina, Brazil, and the United States. More than 4,000 personnel from 13 nations joined forces to assist in the search, tirelessly scouring an expansive area comparable in size to Spain. However, despite the massive scale of operations, the submarine was nowhere to be found. On November 30th, 15 days after the submarine went missing, the Navy made the difficult decision to halt rescue efforts, as all hope for the crew of the ARA San Juan was lost. The heartbreaking decision was made to transition from the rescue phase to the search phase. The focus shifted towards locating the submarine on the seabed, as hope of finding survivors diminished. The loss of all 44 crew members aboard the San Juan marked the largest tragedy involving a submarine since the Chinese submarine 361 experienced a malfunction in April 2003. But who were the crew on board? Among the crew are 43 men, representing the majority. But breaking barriers and shattering stereotypes, there was one remarkable woman on board as well. Her name is Eliana Maria Krawczyk, a 35-year-old trailblazer who holds the distinction of being the first female officer in Argentina to serve on a submarine. The search for the submarine soon turned from days into months, yielding no results. It was like looking for a needle in a haystack. All hope was about to be lost until one day on the 16th of November 2018, 1 year after the submarine went missing. The remains of the ARA San Juan were finally located at a depth of 907 meters, approximately 20 kilometers northwest from the seismic anomaly previously reported by the CTBTO. The significant breakthrough came with the assistance of the Norwegian ship Seabed Constructor, owned by Ocean Infinity, a private maritime company hired by the Argentine government. Equipped with an advanced fleet of autonomous vehicles, Ocean Infinity's remote submersible found the wreckage of the Argentinian submarine following an intensive 2-month search using its autonomous rovers. The confirmation of the discovery was made after meticulous examination of footage from the autonomous rovers, which regularly capture images of the seabed during their exploration. The search contract was valued at $7.5 million, contingent on Ocean Infinity successfully locating the missing submarine. Prior searches for the wreck had faced significant challenges due to limited technology and the presence of numerous submarine canyons in the area, making it challenging to pinpoint the exact location. However, with improved capabilities, the probability of finding the submarine in the identified region was estimated to be around 90%. Photographs from the site revealed the somber sight of the shattered remains of the submarine scattered on the seabed, covering an area of 8,000 square meters. Among the wreckage were the imploded pressure hull, the bow section, sail, and propellers. This bittersweet discovery provided some closure to the families of the crew, although it also served as a solemn reminder of the immense risks and sacrifices faced by submariners. In the quest to unravel the mysteries of the ill-fated San Juan, investigations yielded no definitive answers. However, one particular report stirred the attention of the media, shedding light on a tragic fate. According to acoustic analyst Bruce Rule, the crew are likely to have met their untimely demise as the submarine's hull was obliterated in a mere 40 milliseconds. With a somber calculation, Mr. Rule determined that the energy released during the submarine's collapse was equivalent to the detonation of a staggering 12,500 pounds of TNT, all transpiring at a depth of 1,275 feet beneath the sea's surface. Despite the crew's potential awareness of the impending collapse, they would have been oblivious to the actual implosion. Within an unbelievably brief span of approximately 40 milliseconds, the entire pressure hull was annihilated completely. Mr. Rule, a reputed former lead acoustic analyst at the U.S. Office of Naval Intelligence, known as the nation's premier maritime intelligence service, further stated that the wreckage of the submarine descended vertically at a speed ranging between 10 to 13 knots, deepening the gravity of the tragedy. This haunting analysis provided a glimpse into the swift and devastating events that unfolded within the depths of the sea, offering some understanding of the fate that befell the brave crew of the San Juan. Unfortunately, this was not the last submarine accident to occur. A few years later, the Indonesia submarine, the KRI Nanggala, met a similar tragic fate. Watch this video to find out more.